because they're just so great to watch. Now another laser fan is in a big favor for disc maniacs everywhere, preparing a special laser edition of his own hit movie.
Come with me. Ah, the old editing room floor. Here are a few tidbits that didn't make it into the final cut. Let me just scoop some up for posterity. Put it in the machine.
And that's just what Danny DeVito has done for fans of The War of the Roses, which he directed and co-starred in with Kathleen Turner and Michael Douglas. The Laserdisc edition shows us deleted scenes and alternate shots that DeVito had in mind for his film, but decided not to use in the finished product. Not to mention the entire shooting script, frame by frame, storyboard sketches for different scenes, and stills taken during the production. Danny went to all this trouble for one simple reason. He's a Laserdisc buff and collector himself.
I became like a fanatic. I have everything on disc. And my favorite ones were the collections where the filmmaker would speak and, you know, you'd get storyboards. I mean, you'd get West Side Story. It actually has casting notes and all kinds of stuff.
The best stuff of all comes on the second soundtrack available on Laserdisc. Here, Danny narrates the entire picture like a play-by-play commentator, remarking on everything from how the camera moved when it shouldn't have.
If you really look at it closely, it's swimming all over the place. The thing was bouncing and bopping around, and here I am complaining again. I'm sorry.
To his own appearance on screen.
Boy, am I fat in this movie. Look at that.
In fact, I told Danny that listening to his narration was almost like having him next to me in my living room as we watched the film together.
If you'd invited me over, I might have watched the picture with you, and you wouldn't have seen the disc, and you would have heard what I was going to say anyway.
Hey, if only I'd known. Now, if you folks haven't yet seen or experienced a Laserdisc, I thought I'd show you what it looks like. This is it, like a giant CD. In fact, it's the size of an old record album, 12 inches. Except, unlike a record album, it can't wear out. That's one of the many advantages of this medium. And if you want to tune in this weekend, I'll show you other very interesting material available only on Laser. The Last Picture Show, narrated by its director, Peter Bogdanovich, and Sybil Shepherd. And Raging Bull, narrated by its director, Martin Scorsese. Really interesting stuff.
Ooh, no kidding. Thanks, Leonard.
Thank you, Leonard.
Are becoming the medium of choice for many video junkies these days. Not only because the sound and picture quality are so good, but because many of the deluxe disc packages include some tantalizing extras. Background information on the film, scenes that were deleted, and in several new releases, commentary by the men who made the movies.
Stay here. You won. Let him go first. Stay here. Tell him.
Here's Raging Bull, the film that in two separate critics' polls was named the best picture of the 1980s. How exciting, then, to be able to watch the film and listen to director Martin Scorsese talk about it at the same time.
Now, the film, we did so much violence in the film, but nobody ever got hurt except for this one moment. Right here. You hear that bow? That's real. That's Joe broke his rib. Bob broke Joe's rib there by accident.
Not only do we relive those moments in the making of the picture, but we get to learn about choices the director made and techniques he decided to use.
The point of view of Jake, whenever he really looks over, especially if somebody's with Vicky, becomes pretty obviously slow motion. And it was just a very simplistic idea I had, which was to, you know, sort of burn those images in his memory. And what would burn in, when you remember something like that, you kind of see every movement, and you see the movements accentuated and exaggerated. And that's why we use so much slow motion.
Like other deluxe discs, this set from the Criterion Collection also includes storyboards from the film, the original script, behind the scenes and background material on the real Jake LaMotta, portrayed in the picture by Robert De Niro.
Come on, Sam.
Bye, Sam. Hey, come on.
Night,
Sam. Shoot it like a picture.
Well, good.
The Criterion box set for The Last Picture Show has all of that and more. For one thing, there are some screen tests.
Well, why don't you love me like you used to do? How come you treat me like a worn-out shoe?
And even scouting footage that was taken when the proper locations were being sought for the film. Director Peter Bogdanovich not only discusses his film all the way through, but also got the opportunity to put back some scenes he originally cut in 1971. And he explains why he thinks they're important.
This was a new scene we put in for this release now. And it's one of my favorite scenes and Larry McMurtry's favorite scenes. It's sort of a very important scene showing the three of them together.
We also get to hear from some of the cast members, including Sybil Shepherd, who is making her film debut here, and finding herself faced with the prospect of undressing on screen.
It was horrible doing the nude scenes. I plagued Peter
over and over again. I said, well, I'm going to do these scenes, but I want you to sign, I want you and the producers to sign a form that says that no still photographs will be printed anywhere. And they wouldn't do it.
A more recent movie hit has also received the deluxe Laserdisc treatment, The War of the Roses from Image Laserdisc. And the reason this came about is that its director and co-star, Danny DeVito, is himself a Laserdisc fanatic. Again, it's a lot of fun to hear a director doing play-by-play commentary on his own movie.
There's a great moment coming up that I saw immediately while we were doing it. Michael Douglas punches the pillow there because he knows that his key light is coming from the left. I love that. I mean, he's just a consummate artist when it comes to filmmaking. And look at the rewards he gets. He gets to sit in bed with Kathleen Turner. That warm, luscious, sweetie pie.
And when I asked Danny how he compared the experience of watching his film on cassette to seeing and hearing it on laser, his reply was immediate and eloquent.
Well, I mean, it's the difference between sitting on the stoop in the summer in Brooklyn, you know, or going to Tahiti and laying out in the beach, you know what I mean?
It really is true. If you do a side-by-side comparison of cassette quality and laser quality, it is an astonishing difference. But the real fun is getting all those extras on a lot of those deluxe laser discs. They're worth having and certainly worth seeing.
Leonard, you've done some narration for some of these, haven't you?
I did one. I did the narration for A Night at the Opera on the Criterion Collection. It was a lot of fun, but it was very tough to talk about one movie for 90 minutes.
You just keep rattling on about it?
Yes, I did. To talk about everything I could think of.
Oh, no, I've seen him do it. Thanks, Leonard.
Thanks, Leonard.
All of which leads...
...suffered when they've been squeezed down for home viewing. Leonard Maltin joins us now to show us all that we've been missing, Leonard.
Well, John, people love watching movies on video, but when you take a movie made for showing in theaters and watch it at home, are you getting the whole picture? If that film was made in a widescreen process like CinemaScope or Panavision, the answer is no. That's why the folks who make video laserdiscs, which appeal to film connoisseurs, release so many of them in a special format, as Warner Home Video has done with The Music Man.
In a theater, we're used to seeing a movie like The Music Man in its original Technirama widescreen format. But most of us see these films on television, in what is called the flat version, where about a third of the picture is eliminated. And for real fans of the movie, that means one thing.
We got trouble!
Oh, we got trouble!
Right here in River City! With a capital T, and that rhymes with P, and that stands for pool!
Some movies just don't work well at all on television broadcasts or on flat home videotapes. The Forbidden Planet Laserdiscs from MGM UA Home Video and the Voyager Company are presented in the original CinemaScope versions. But in flat television prints, the same scene is treated like this. And that leaves a lot of film fans very disappointed.
Why haven't I seen this all along?
Partly because so many people dislike those black bars at the top and bottom of widescreen or letterboxed prints of popular films. But the alternative, in a 1950s movie like Oklahoma that used all of its wide screen, is having Shirley Jones disappear from the side of the frame. And the pan and scanning machine acing out Gordon McRae off the other side of the picture.
Let's go!
Another television perennial is The Longest Day, a film some people don't even realize was shot in widescreen simply because of repeated exposure in the flat version. It's difficult to imagine capturing the breadth and scope of the D-Day invasion any other way, now that the Image Laserdisc has done so. Another World War II epic, The Great Escape, seems unnatural in widescreen, and on the Voyager disc, that's what you get. These scenes practically demand it, and yet many TV prints have Steve McQueen spending time in the cooler, bouncing his baseball off of, well, it's hard to tell. Where's Michael Caine in this shot from The Man Who Would Be King? Right here in widescreen. The latest adventure to make a widescreen debut on Laserdisc is Dances with Wolves, a film where the sweep and beauty of the American prairie is best shown in widescreen. But as early as the opening credits, the shortcomings of the flat version are apparent when compared to the widescreen original. And finally, Apocalypse Now has been re-released by Paramount Home Video in a dazzling widescreen Laserdisc that's not only been remastered for sound and color, but is being issued for the first time ever in its original widescreen format. So now, Laserdisc viewers have more ammunition than ever to extol the virtues of the letterbox format.
What do you think?
Wow, this is really exciting, man.
It is exciting for Laserdisc owners because this is now being rated one of the best Laserdiscs of all time, the new Apocalypse Now, newly mixed for sound, newly mastered for picture. This is the kind of thing that's happening on a regular basis now at all the Laserdisc companies. So it's really turning a lot of people on to a medium they never thought about before.
Great. Thanks, Leonard. Mm-hmm.